Come and say hi, you people.
Hi, hello.
Hiya.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Good morning guys, welcome to a new vlog. It has really been a while I vlogged. Although I just posted a video yesterday, but the last time I actually picked up this camera was, I think, over a month ago. But today I want to just try and vlog because I've been having one of the best times of my life. Like, I really be having a good time, although I've not picked up the camera to vlog, but let me just try. So yeah, so today I plan to go to work late. No particular reason. Every day I go to work really early. I go to work before 7 a.m. but today I'm going to take my time. I'll go to work probably 8:30 or 9 because my shed is really light. And today I just have SR ward rounds. That's ward rounds with the senior residents, and that is all. So I'm going to, you know, take my time and relax before going to work. So I'm ready for work now. Just want to pack my bags and leave. I have to go see my patients this morning, check up on them, how they are doing. And then also we have to prepare the patients for theater tomorrow. We're doing a hymenotomy, so someone with fibroids, the process of removing the fibroids is hymenotomy. So that is the surgical procedure we have to do tomorrow. So the patient was admitted yesterday, so today we're just going to prepare the patient, ensure they have everything needed for the surgery ahead of tomorrow. But I'm ready for work now. Oh, you guys, I got a new piercing. Let me show you guys. It's still painful. I got it like 2 days ago. Still painful, but I like it.
Today was my theater day, so we did the hymenotomy I told you guys about. But my call is really calm. I've just seen one patient today, somebody with threatened miscarriage, but that's all. I'm in gynae emergency, so all gynae related cases that are coming in will come to me.
The pathology of each segment of the tube has an impact with pregnancy outcome. What are the risk factors for tubal disease? We have the congenital and the acquired risk factors.
We don't suck at the OPV now, it's always a sucker. Come inside where?
Hi guys, good morning. This clip might be quite noisy because like a lot of cars are moving, but how are you guys doing? I'm currently on labor ward duty this week, so like basically I leave my unit and then I am just in labor ward for the entire week. And also you don't do calls, so you just work 8 to 4 in the labor ward every day for the week. So that's my week. And yesterday, which was Tuesday, like we had no patients coming, like at all. Literally, when labor ward, and not even one patient. walked in, so we didn't have anything to do yesterday, but let's see how today goes. I mean, I was really glad that no patient came in yesterday because I was not even mentally prepared to be at work. But yeah, I'm looking forward to today. I'm sure they are going to be patients, but let's see how that goes. Open up a bottle, and baby, you can have whatever you want. You taste so sweet, I can't help myself. You like candy, you like liquid honey. You taste so sweet, I can't help myself. You like candy, you like liquid honey. Oh, ah.
I came to look for what to eat, but this restaurant does not have food, and I just got a call. I ordered skincare products from Dang, Diary of a Naija Girl. I ordered it this morning and it is 1 o'clock and it has arrived, so I need to go pick it up. I'm so excited. I'll show you guys later. When I pick it up, I'll go look for what to eat because I am still hungry.
Hi guys, I just got back from work. Today we only had one patient, a woman that came in with premature rupture of membrane. So that is like your water breaking before you are term. Yes. Well, anyways, let's go to the fun stuff. This is my order. I ordered from Diary of a Naija Girl, like I said. Like this morning, I was just like let me just do this once and for all, because I've been seeing people using her products and like I've been seeing so much positive review. And as much as my skin is clear, I may not have breakouts, but my skin is actually quite rough, and I've tried so many ways to like stop it, but I don't really know what I'm doing wrong. But I've seen people with similar problems and they have used some of our products and there has been good review. So like, I'm so surprised it came so fast. Like this morning, I ordered at 7 a.m. and by like 1 o'clock, it was already here. Ooh, this is the packaging. Let's open it together. I bought 2 products actually. Okay, this is the niacinamide N-acetyl glucosamine serum, and this is the vitamin C serum. So I'm really excited to try them out. I'm going to start this night. But yeah, from what I was seeing on her Instagram, it was like use the vitamin C in the morning and use the niacinamide in the evening. So that is what I'm going to be doing. Hi guys, good morning. I'm getting ready for work. It's about 7:30 a.m. I want to use this vitamin C serum this morning. So today, I told you guys I am on labor ward duty. So basically what we do is every woman that is in labor or any complications related to labor. Oh, I think I put a lot. Complications related to labor or delivery, pregnancy, things like that, you come to the labor ward. So we deal with you. So we do all the deliveries and all the emergency cesarean sections, all the women that maybe they've been booked for CS already, but before their date, you know, something happens. We manage everything like that in the labor ward. So that's why, you know, it's possible that no patients will come in. And I feel like this period, there are not a lot of women giving birth. So like, I feel like one of the hot seasons for labor ward is going to be like end of the year. All these ember months, I feel like there are so many deliveries, especially September. There are so many deliveries in September, but for now, we don't have a lot of women coming in. So today in my unit, although I'm not in the unit this week, but we have an interesting case. We have a girl with imperforate hymen.
So that is like the hymen, that's the thing that covers the vagina, is closed, so there's no entry into the vagina. So usually most girls don't really notice this until they're about to start menstruation, and then blood starts to accumulate, and then that's when they start having problems. So this girl presented with like difficulty urinating, and then, you know, figured out that she has imperfect hymen. So this surgery is hymenotomy. You're trying to like open the hymen and create like the opening whereby blood can come out for menstruation, and, you know, vagina will be open. This is the explanation in layman's terms. So although I'm not in the unit, if I have free time in the labor ward today, I want to go up to theater and, you know, join my units for this case, because I feel like it's very interesting. And I'm almost done with ONG, and it's the first time I'm seeing this type of case, so I really want to join. That's why I wear my scrubs, so that I will just sneak into theater and I can just easily sneak out back to the labor ward if anything comes up. But yeah, that is it. Is there anything else I've done, you guys? Oh, I like how this thing feels on my face. Feels so good. I bought the oily one because, like I said, I have dry skin. This is vitamin C. So I think that's all for now. If there's anything else, I'll let you guys know. So let me go to work now, and I'll talk to you guys later. To be without you, I don't feel whole. Look what you've done to me now. I'm in the call room now. I just came in. I want to first of all go to the labor ward, see what is happening. Was there any case from yesterday that they will hand over to us? If there's nothing, I'll go up to theater, see if my unit members are ready for the first case. Oh yes, they just told me the first case is the case I'm interested in. They're also having my hymenotomy for, like I said before, to remove fibroids, for those of you that are not in the medical field. So I'll go to labor ward now. Hopefully today is calm, because I really want to watch this hymenotomy. So yeah, fingers crossed. I'll update you guys how that goes. You got a body that you always find. Open up a bottle, and baby, you can have whatever you want. You taste so sweet, I can't help myself. You like candy. Hi guys, so I just got back from work. Today I went to theater. We didn't have any new patients coming, only the patients that was handed over to us from those that were on call in the night. So we just managed, I was a case of preeclampsia. So that is like people that have high blood pressure that developed during pregnancy, that were not hypertensive before pregnancy. So like the blood pressure is very, very high. So yeah, that is like layman's terms explanation of that. And then as we were leaving, like five minutes past four, a new patient just came in. But then our like duty is over at 4 o'clock, so those on call will take over, so they will sort out that patient. Anyways, most of today I had to do I had to go for a meeting because I have a presentation tomorrow. I want to tell you guys about it. But I have a presentation tomorrow. My unit for the whole department, so we'll be presenting to the whole department. So our topic is like a case of a woman with urinary incontinence. So the topic is just all around urinary incontinence. So we have just been working on it with me, the registrar, the senior registrar, and our moderator, which is the consultant. So we had to meet. She had to see our work and ensure it was ready. We still have some corrections to make though, but yeah. Then I also have a presentation, like my personal presentation to my own unit, which is for next week. I've been working on that too. I'm presenting normal labor. No, labor is like a very broad topic, but I will try and just pick out, you know, some important things and just present. So I've been working on that also. But yeah, that's all for now. Just go back. I want to eat, rest, and just chill for the rest of the evening. Let me show you guys the book I'm currently reading. So it is this book. Let me go back to the front page. It's in my hand. This is the title. It is called The Almanac of Navarabicans. It's a guide to wealth and happiness. I've really been enjoying reading this book so far. I just found it on, I think, Twitter or Instagram. Someone posted it. And immediately, on Instagram, it was an Instagram caption to a picture. And they posted where they got the quotes from. Immediately, I went to the book. And I have been loving it so far. I'm just taking my time to digest it.
So the time is 9 p.m. I finished reading that book I showed you guys. I said that some days ago, so I was reading quite slowly. Anyways, ahead of my presentation tomorrow, I'm just watching some videos on urinary incontinence, trying to have more understanding on the topic. Just in case they ask me any questions, I'll be able to answer. Because basically, my work is to present the case, the history, examinations, investigations, findings. Yes, and then my senior colleague would, discuss, management, treatment, more on the history and more on the investigations. While the most senior colleagues would talk about research done, evidences, why some methods are better than others. So although I will just be presenting the case, they can decide to still ask me questions. So I need to have a good understanding of the different types of urinary incontinence. So yeah, that's what I'm trying to do now before I just go to bed.
Is due to a weakening of muscles that support the pelvis and pelvic structures. So these muscles can weaken over time. So increasing age.
Hi guys, good morning. It is 7:50 a.m. I'm ready for work. And my presentation, the meeting actually starts by 8:30. But I think I'll get to present at 9. That's when the presentation will start. I'm just ready to do it and get it over with. Because I still have another presentation to work on. But yeah, I hope today is a really calm day. I mean, the whole week has been calm. But yeah, I want today to be calm so I can finish working on my other presentation. But whatever happens, I'll let you guys in. And maybe I'll get some clips of myself presenting. If not, then just know it went well. Because it definitely will go well. But yeah, it's raining, but I have to go to work now.
And it's not working out as you thought. Don't compare your situation with any other woman's. Look at your own particular situation and understand the context of where you are.
Mm-hmm.
And within your own context, work out your salvation. Determine exactly how you play to win in that scenario without losing sight of what your end goal is. And whatever works for you to achieve that, that's what you do. Don't care what anybody else is doing. Because the problem for women as well is, oh, you listen to your friends, you listen to your neighbors, to your aunties. How can you listen to your, how can your husband say that? How can this? Once you make the choice that this is the man I married, and this is where I want to go. No. Now, the point is, where I'm sitting, how do I make this work for me? What are the things I need to adjust? What are sometimes the sacrifices or sometimes the decisions that you need to make? Because it's about opportunity cost. What do I consider more important in my life that I want to sacrifice for? And how far am I willing to go in terms of the sacrifice for the things that I want to achieve? When you answer those questions, you then decide. Now, it's the kind of situation where I can only speak to you in a coaching session.
Hi guys, good morning. I didn't think this vlog was going to be extended till now. Anyways, it's Saturday morning. So after 1 week of doing duty in labor ward and not doing calls, on this Saturday, you now do a call in labor ward. So I'm on call in the labor ward today. It's about 15 minutes to 8. Call starts by 8, so I'm just getting ready to go to work. Yeah, but at the same time, I think I'm going to end this video here. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you want more medical videos like this, what I do at work, let me know in the comment section, because sometimes I feel like you guys don't enjoy watching this type of videos based on like the analytics I see, the views that this type of videos get. But just let me know in the comment section so that I can still do a few of these just for those that still want to watch it. So yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye bye.